Welcome back, everyone, to our prayer journey with my Tote. Today, I'm doing this video for what I started the main purpose of videos for in the first place, because God laid it on my heart that maybe people can get saved, that people would start praying, and that people that are stuck in the mud would get going. And those people who come to a knowledge of Jesus Christ, who found out that no sin is too big to be forgiven when you come to Jesus Christ through the Holy Spirit and get saved and become born again. But this question always arises when someone becomes a new believer and is born again. What do I do next? I did two other videos on this, and both of them kind of emphasize, which I'm going to emphasize a little bit here, walking in the Spirit, being in the Spirit of God and allowing Him to guide you where to be. I hope if you've been saved for a period of time that you have found a good church. If not, do not give up. Go back to the Holy Spirit and pray for direction. Let nothing stand you in the way. You know, the reason I'm doing this particular video, as I was reading in Colossians, I realized He's got a formula here. He's got a formula for you to plant a stake in Jesus Christ. You know, in a sense, we all planted the stake into His arms and hands and pierced His side. But now we can plant a stake in the ground with Jesus, to take a stand and walk with Him in the Spirit. And listen what Paul writes here in Colossians 2:6. As ye have therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so ye walk in Him. You need to walk in the Spirit of God. The first step, really, once we're walking with the Spirit, is to walk with Jesus Christ in a way that we trust Him with all things. He follows up with this. In fact, I'm going to read these two verses together. As ye have therefore received Jesus Christ the Lord, so walk ye in Him. Rooted and built up in Him and established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Paul never visited these Colossian people, but rather one of his either disciples or people who came to knowledge of the faith in him had witnessed to people in this particular town, and he had taught them a little bit, and now he's on with Paul, and he's, I think, trying to get Paul to visit. But Paul is an apostle, big man, going at big places. He only could be one place at one time, and he writes them this letter to be walking in Christ and to be walking in the Spirit and to root themselves in Him, to plant the stake in the ground with Jesus. You know, when my tomato plants start to grow, I put a stake in the ground and I fix everything to that plant so it doesn't fall and crack and break. And I found they grow pretty good as a vine too, but I got to keep them up so that they don't really lose the fruit that they have on it. So this is what Jesus is talking up here. Root yourself in Jesus. Built up in Jesus. Building yourself up. How do you do that? You're in the Word of God. You're following the Spirit of God. You're walking with God. And then what happens? You will be established in the faith. You will be walking with God. You'll have your own foundation firm and secure. Because you know what's going to happen? I have seen this on some of these people have gotten saved in my life. And even now on video where some people have gotten saved and they had some problems about them. He's writing to these people in this world of Colossae that are up against different things. Polytheism, against philosophies, against science so-called. And they're pulling at them away. You know, I had an experience with a couple of people who have gotten saved on this channel who have, for a while, prayed to other gods without even realizing it was an error. But I didn't say anything. God worked in them and started to show them that Jesus is the only way, truth, and life. Only Jesus can answer your prayer. Only Jesus we need to press that stake in and walk with him. And I've seen these people come around, and without me ever saying a word, because the Holy Spirit did a work in them. And I've seen this even in my regular life with Christians who first got saved, and they're into so many different things, and slowly it starts to peel off because they see the power of Jesus Christ. Now, here's the other thing that we need to do for those who say, I want to follow Jesus. What's next? What am I supposed to do? And you start following? Hold on. You're established in the faith. In verse 8 here, where I'm going to end, it says, beware, lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after traditions of men and the rudiments of this world, and not after Christ. What is that saying? Hold on to that stake. Don't let Jesus Christ depart from you. Do not listen to these people that are trying to pull you away. Don't get pulled into spiritualism and different things. Hold fast to Jesus Christ. You know, we planted a stake when we weren't saved in Jesus to harm him because of our sin. Now plant a stake in the ground and hug on to Jesus and don't let go. And then you can say with me that let Jesus increase as we decrease. Until next time, may Jesus bless each and every one of you.